We are in the office of Mrs. Lamia Radi, the Moroccan ambassador in Oslo. Magnil, Ahmed, and the ambassador are working on the final details of Petit Prince, a solidarity operation by the Lycée René Cassin, the French school in Oslo. It's for nomadic children for a region in South Morocco. The school children collected clothes, books, and scholastic material, which will be transported to Morocco and distributed to children in need.
You know, as diplomats, one of our role is to make the people in the country we are sent or we are accredited to understand and knows us a little bit more. So one aspect of this project is that it explains to the Norwegian population that Morocco is a country of pluralism and diversity, because it explains to these people, and especially to children, that in Morocco there are Amazigh people, which is Berber people, they are Hassani people, who are Bedouins, nomads, and they are Arabs. So through the operation Little Princes, Petit Prince, it's an opportunity for the children and to their parents to understand that the essence of Morocco is diversity of culture and of population. We called it Petit Prince because the book, The Little Prince of Antoine de Saint-Exupéry, is an universally known a book. Everybody knows, everybody has read this book or heard about it. But very few of them know that this story happens in Morocco, because Antoine de Saint-Exupéry was head of the airport of Cap Juby, actually 90 years ago. And that's when he was there, and he stayed there several years, that he got inspiration to write this book. So communicating for us through the image of Petit Prince makes people understand and know Morocco better.
My name is Ahmed Haja. It's from Mahamed El Ghizlan of south of Morocco. It is a small village by the desert. It's named Mahamed El Ghizlan. That's old name. It's Mohammed. It's Hamada, the flat desert. And El Ghizlan, it's a gazelle plural animals. And I work in tourism, and our history, it started in 2002 when I was working guide in the desert, and I meet Madame Mangal Ulven, really from Norway. She was there in trip with her daughter, and they were guiding them for 3 days in the desert. And it was a wonderful trip, even if the first day was really windy. It was a big experience for her, for Norwegian, first time in the desert. And it was really interesting area for her and the culture, especially culture and the nature. And after trip, we was talking about the trip and what happened and everything. Then she asked me why we can do something together to bring Scandinavian people in the desert and at the same time do something for help nomad people, especially children in the desert, because in the trip we meet some children in the desert, in the oasis, and you know they don't have enough shoes for walking and like clothes. Then we give them some sweets and some shoes, and it was idea why not to bring people and at the same time help the children to make them happy and smiling. Then we decided to start the company in 2003.
What I saw when I was in Sahara was the children. They had nothing. I come from Norway and are used to children with everything and more than everything. And with Ahmed's mind and my own Norwegian mind, we had the idea to help some of these children. We can't take it all, but we can make it better for somebody. And so this is actually a kind of burning dream for all these years, to make something for those children. So now we are here today. We have had traveling business for 15 years almost. Norwegian travelers and others have take with them some stuff to the children, but it's okay, very good to make it more organized, to collect the money, to have transport, because without transport, it's no school. And to go to school, they also need some materials, they need some clothes, and this is what we want to help them with.
But I want to help people because I live in the desert. I born in Sahara, and I live 9 years in the desert, and I know what is mean child life in the desert without any shoes, without any good condition living lives, and without any schools. And then always I have, when I see some child, I remember that was something in my life. For that I will try, and I try to make some children in the desert or in the kasbas or in the villages to be happy and to share with them some moment.
Of course, there is more operational dimension of the project, which is to encourage the Norwegian people to go to Mohammed Rizlan and to discover the desert, and at the same time, operationally, to give a hand to the nomad schools that are in Hamid Rizlan. There are schools for the children, nomad camps, and so they need many things. And it happens that there is this agency that does sustainable tourism there, and we wanted to give them a hand. And of course, we called. So that was also another reason to call this operation Petit Prince, because in Morocco, children we call them Amir at home. So all those children that grows in the desert, they are our children. So they are our little princes for us.
Donc le projet en question, c'était l'idée de récolter bon nombre de vêtements, de jouets et de livres aussi scolaires qui pourraient intéresser des tribus nomades, hein, les enfants nomades de Mamil Kislen, hein, tribu du Maroc, qui a besoin voilà, de bon nombre de choses. Donc très rapidement, nous avons organisé donc une collecte, hein, auprès des différents enseignants et des parents. Et je me suis aperçu qu'effectivement, il y avait vraiment un enthousiasme grand, hein, avec bon nombre de choses qui étaient récupérées. Donc l'idée maintenant, c'est bien de poursuivre ce projet jusqu'à ce que l'école se termine, hein, jusqu'à fin juin. Sachant qu'ensuite, il y aura donc une présentation du projet à travers un petit film qui retracera justement tout le projet, du début à la fin, que sont devenus les objets en fait. Hein. Et puis surtout, renouveler l'expérience au fil des années, sachant qu'à partir de l'an prochain, donc, ce sera intéressant de mettre en place des projets pédagogiques en lien. C'est-à-dire faire réfléchir les enfants sur ce qui s'est passé et puis réfléchir aux autres cultures, aux autres besoins des autres enfants et bien d'autres choses encore.
Et quand tu dis des affaires, c'est quoi exactement?
C'est des sacs, des vêtements, du matériel de classe, des trousses.
Et c'est des vêtements d'été seulement?
Non, il y a des vêtements chauds, à manches courtes, à manches longues, légers.
Et du coup, en fait, on range des affaires qui étaient pour nous, et pour ces gens qui sont dans le désert, et comme ça, on leur donne nos affaires. Et genre, s'ils ont du bébé, on leur donne nos affaires.
D'accord, et j'ai cru comprendre aussi que dans le désert, la nuit, il faisait froid.
Oui, il faisait très 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 froid.
Et oui, c'est pour ça qu'il avait besoin de vêtements chauds aussi.
Oui, de vêtements bien chauds.
D'accord. Our company, Sjøvik, was founded back in 1903. It was my great-grandfather and his two brothers. They bought the first boat named Brothers. And then later it has been several different kind of smaller boats, bigger boats, also bigger factory vessels. Now I'm representing the fourth generation. Together with my brothers and myself and my father, we are now running the business, mainly within the fisheries. We have been involved in different projects all over the world, in Africa, in South America, in Australia. We have today we have 200 people employed in Sjøvik, Morocco. The offices are in Casablanca and in Dakhla, where also the factory is located. When the embassy of Morocco in Oslo asked us to be involved in the project Les Petits Princes, we thought this was a very good opportunity to be able to give back even more to people that really need it. We have got a lot of friends and good relationship partners in Morocco, and we feel obliged to, and also we are proud to be able to give something back to the society. We hope this project will benefit a lot of children and adults in the village, and we are very proud to be a part of it.
We are in Casablanca, the economic capital of Morocco. The first part of the Petit Prince operation has been a success. The material collected by the French school amounts to approximately 700 kilos. In the port of Casablanca, we catch up with Manghil, Ahmed, and Mohamed Beshna, the president of the Bonu Solidarity Association. Mohamed will be responsible for the distribution of the donated items. The materials are quickly loaded onto the truck on loan from the town of Mohamed Ghislain, especially for the occasion. We meet Zaid, who will be responsible for the valuable goods on the more than 700 kilometer road trip separating us from the south of Morocco. After more than 10 hours on the road, we arrive in the small village of Bonu, our final destination. Despite the late arrival, a magnificent welcome is waiting for us. These are the parents and members of Bono Association of Solidarity. And there is no welcome in Morocco without the traditional mint tea we must taste before unloading the truck.
Et tous les gens vous remercient pour tout. Et surtout les élèves, parce que demain on va rencontrer les élèves ainsi que les instituteurs, les professeurs des élèves. Et on va organiser la donation pour tous les élèves des écoles du Bono. Et les élèves qui de Bono qui partent à Mohamed et vont partir au désert pour l'école des déserts. Et on va distribuer à eux aussi cette donation.
مايدي لا دينا اين سنار على غير زكوغا وليدي خصني
اي جور دوي اوني سي pour faire le triage des vêtements pour les petits, les grands et les filles, les garçons. et ainsi que pour les accessoires les accessoires scolaires. Et lorsqu'on finit de cette action, on va partir aux écoles pour la distribution.
Sorting is clearly a matter for men. While they are sorting these goods, two women with a baby approach Mangnil to find out what's happening. Distributing will be done equally. Every child will receive a box with the exact same contents, and more than 40 boxes will be prepared in a record time for an immediate distribution.
Today we was giving school material, bags and the box and the clothes for children in school at Bunu, about 41 child. And today we are working now to bring stuff to the desert, to the school in Sahara. We should drive 2 hours and a half off road. Then we arrive there for give them the stuff.
We now take the truck off into the desert to get to the most isolated school in the sector. The temperature at the end of September is close to 44 degrees Celsius at noon. And Ahmed monitors the temperature of the engine to keep it from overheating. We have the chance to meet a few camels coming for a refreshing drink at the oasis. The desert landscape changes regularly, sometimes sandy, sometimes stony. One must know the terrain in order not to get lost on the many tracks we take. We finally get to the school in the desert after 2.5 hours off tracks. In this windswept plain stands a nomadic tent, which is the school for the children in this sector. And although it's Saturday afternoon, the children rush to meet us. The teachers have told them about our arrival. And inside the tent is a fully functioning classroom. Children sit at their desks, and Ahmed, Mohammed, and Mangnil cannot resist playing the professor.
Yes, very good.
Then it's time to distribute books and some toys. These children are much more reserved than the ones from the village school. The atmosphere is serious, but despite their shyness, some allow themselves to play in front of us with what they have just received.
Pour nous, on a partagé la donation par élève, c'est-à-dire le nombre des élèves qui sont aux deux écoles, de Jdara Achra et de Bounou, parce qu'ils sont tous des écoles de Bounou. Ici, on a fait une autre division, mais on a partagé par famille. Comment vous dites Zahra, à deux Zahra. صالح محمد هذا ولدي هذا صالح مزار بن صالح هذا ولدي هذا اكيد هذا تاع هذا ايش سميت هيك ايش ما تقول هيك انت صبطني
We reluctantly leave those very endearing children to finish our tour. We return to the trucks with a stop at the fantastic Jbar travel camp for tourists. This camp is located at the foot of the most beautiful sand dunes in Morocco. The stop is once again too short. We must go back to meet a nomad family settled not far from the camp. We meet a new caravan of camels. Ahmed seems to know everyone in the desert. And when we visit the family, the Solidarity Project makes sense because these people live in a very precarious situation. Mohammed gives the last box filled with clothes and toys to their little girl. The operation ends here, in the heart of the Moroccan desert, with this exceptionally welcoming family every day facing the harshness of the wilderness. We can say without hesitation that this first edition is a success, and it will be followed by many others.